words, but I love the message. Higher than the mountains that I face, stronger than the power of the grave, constant through the trials and the change. One thing remains, one thing remains. I like that verse. Higher than the mountains that I face, and we face some high ones. It's even stronger than the power of the grave, constant through the trials and the change. One thing remains, one thing remains. I like this. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love. And on and on and on and on it goes. Yes, it overwhelms and satisfies my soul. And I never ever have to be afraid. One thing remains. Oh, one thing. Out on me, your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Runs out on me. I know your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love, your love.
Yeah.
Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Woke up this morning and smiled with the rising sun. About a thing.
message to you. Say don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Everybody don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Every little thing is gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. You don't have to worry, it's gonna be. All right, yeah. Don't worry, don't worry. Oh, oh, don't worry, don't worry. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry.
Good morning, One Love family. Welcome on in. Happy Sunday to you. I am projecting vibrational frequency of blessing, joy, love, and peace to you all right through whatever device you are watching this on, whether it's on your phone or an iPad or tablet, computer, laptop, whatever it may be, across your television. I'm sending you love. I'm sending you peaceful, loving energy, and sharing that love with you today. Thankful for the music this morning. Thankful for the blessings that we have in our life from multiple people who are talented from around this planet who share their love with us. And I'm just grateful, grateful also for all of you. I hope you've had a great week. I feel like our meditations this week were powerful. I feel like that our midweek connection was also powerful. And I really feel like that we are in a season of shift and change. We're in a season right now of experiencing death, burial, and resurrection, experiencing what it is to narrow the gap, I believe, between what we're believing for and the manifestation of it. And I believe that we all can have that as a part of our life and a part of our current experience. It's possible for all of us. You know, I've been thinking a lot because we've come through the Easter season, thinking a lot about the Jesus person and the Christ of mystery, even more than the Jesus person. The Jesus of history is fantastic, but the Christ of mystery is even higher or greater than that. And realizing the uniqueness of Jesus, but not the specialness of Jesus. When you say someone is special, you're saying that someone else is not as special. And the reality is that Jesus was no more special than any of you, any or myself or anyone else. But he was a unique iteration, manifestation, and an emanation of the divine. And you can be too. He recognized his divinity and you can do the same. And just thinking about the process through which Jesus unfolded his conscious, higher consciousness self, showing us the Christed nature that we all can live in. And as I've thought about that more, the more I've thought about it during this season and the solar eclipse that just transpired and the new moon and everything that's going on with spring and new life being seen around us seeing the process of what it looks like, because we go through seasons for reasons. They're not, you know, sometimes if we don't look at the depth of them, we don't understand that this is all a process, that life has a process to it. Tao is how, and creation is the process. Creation is the manifestation of it. The pure presence, the source, is the how, is the power from which it all comes to be. And the manifestation is the life that we see and the lives that we get to see. And we also get to later rest old ways of being and resurrect new ways of being. All of us have that power within us. And today I'm grateful, 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 grateful to share that with you as just a special reminder of the powerful beings that you are. I'm going to ask you if you would take just a moment, receive a deep breath, and give it back. We come into this moment with gratitude, with thanksgiving. We come into this moment with surrender, a sense of excitement and expectation as well. We are blessed to have this freedom of our true selves, to have tapped into the truth of who we are, and to be able to live from that space of freedom, no longer bound to belief systems or to dogmas, but free, free to truly be our authentic, essential, and original selves. So today, as we drop off even more of what we are not and possibly uncover and discover, recover our even more of our true identity, we say thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And we say, Spirit of Truth, take from us what we don't need. Take from us what we don't need. Bring to us what we do need. Take us where you will. Bring to us what you will. We are surrendered. We are surrendered. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk on the water wherever you'd call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander. And my faith is made stronger in this pure presence. We're grateful. We're thankful. We're blessed. Love is who I am. Gratitude is my attitude. Abundance is my nature. Well-being is my birthright. And so it is. And so it is. Is. And I invite you today into chapter 90. We're in chapter 90 of 100 of Pastor DE's book, Fully Awake. And I love even the title of this chat today. And the title of it is Matrix, Mind, Mouth, Manifestation. Matrix, Mind, Mouth, Manifestation. This is a really a unique, I think, and creative way to talk about perception, the mind thinking, what the mouth is saying, and what we're creating out in the world. Pastor DE starts with this affirmation, and this is for us today. Life and death are in the power of how I see and say. My matrix processes it. My mind presents it. My mouth proclaims it. My manifestation produces it. Today I will be aware of the matrix, the mind, the mouth, manifestation, connection. Pastor DE says, one of the most popular verses in the Bible is that death and life are in the power of the tongue. This verse assures us that the power is not in life or in death. The power is in the tongue. But when we think this through, the power is actually not in the tongue either. The power is in the mind that controls and tells the tongue what to say. James 3 and 8 says this, who can tame the tongue? A masterful mind tames the tongue. A masterful mind tames the tongue. So life and death are in the power of the mind. Yet, if we look a little more deeply, the mind is actually a servant of the matrix, the filters, the theological framework, the sociological grid work, that all discriminate, decide, and deliver what gets to the mind and how. Matrices like education, experience, and exposure. Filters like culture, country, and class. All of this unseen force field decides how and what information gets to the mind. Finally, we arrive at the matrix, the origin. Death and life are in the power of the matrix, or the filters of information. And that matrix filters the information to the mind that controls the mouth. Our mission. Listen to this, please. Our mission as awakened spirits is twofold. First, we must be aware of this matrix, this mind, and our mouth and manifestation connection. And that our lives are manifestations, or manifestations are directly connected to how we process information
and then choose to declare it. Second, we must ask the Holy Spirit to remove the filters, take away the biases, delete the prejudices, extract the religious leanings and cultural learnings so that we can perceive neutrally, purely, clearly, and cleanly whatever the Holy Spirit sends to us. This way, we are not merely manifesting with our mouths, minds, and matrices, more separation and segregation into the global human family. As I've said to you before, I'll remind us again. We don't see the world as it is, we see it as we are. We don't even see theological ideas as it is presented. We see it as we are. There's always a spin. There's always a bend. Until we get to the place where we're able to transcend, and I go back to what we talked about weeks ago when we talked about the different levels of thinking, the different dimensions of thinking. Possibly four, maybe more, but for sure I know these four exist. Absolute thinking, where that's just the way it is. We concretize, we make something solid. There's no fluidity or any kind of bendability to it. It's just the way it is. It's very rigid. And I'll promise you this, a rigid and an immature mind is unable to see the beauty in myths or in mysteries. Unwilling to. Because this is just the way it is. So that's absolute thinking. And then there's abstract thinking. And abstract thinking invites a little bit of conversation, some discussion, has a little bit of leeway, is willing to kind of bend or shift a little bit. And then there's mystical receptivity. In other words, you are receptive to the mystery. You allow yourself to think more in terms of abstract, and it's a possibility that I'm seeing this foggy. And the ultimate way to think, in my personal opinion, is from a place of oneness. That's where your matrix has exploded. You have blown up the idea. You have destroyed basically the idea. You've pounded out and gotten rid of the idea that there's any one particular way of seeing it. In other words, you've transcended dogma. You've transcended fundamentalism. You've gotten above the matrix and you're able to look down on it and say, I can appreciate Buddhism. I can appreciate Christianity. I can appreciate Islam. I can appreciate Hinduism. I can appreciate Judaism. I can appreciate all of these different belief systems. I can look at them and say, I deeply appreciate them and notice that there are truths in all of them. Notice that there's wonderful traditions and cultural ideals in all of them. And at the same time, be able to recognize that God, the source of all creation, is none of those. It's not branded. You can't brand God. It would be the opposite. God would be branding us. But even God doesn't choose a particular religion. Even the scriptures, when it talks about Jesus, says that Jesus, for God so loved the world, this whole thing, the entire universe, the entire galaxy. For God so loved the world. God is not a Christian or a Buddhist or a Muslim or a Jew or a Hindu. God is not picking your political party or your particular religious bend or experience and expression. God is bigger than that. Now, for us to be able to get to a place where we can see that, as Jesus told Nicodemus, you must be born again so that you can see the magnificent kingdom of God. The expanse, the wide open expanse of all that's possible, the wonder and the beauty of the wide open land of eternity. In order to be able to get to that space, someone has to be willing to move through the absolute, the abstract, the mystery receptivity, the mystical abilities, and to receive the mystical. Some people call it woo-woo. And be able to advance even further than that, that you can look down on the woo-woo, you can look down on the mystery, and you can look down on the rigidity, and still be able to see that in some way it all belongs. And start to move toward not having a judgment for any of it. But we need to be able to admit, though, that what we're dealing with how we're showing up in the world, what we're manifesting in the world, is a direct result of our matrix. It's a direct result of our mind and our way of thinking. It's a direct result of our mouths, what we're saying, not just with these physical mouths, but with our activity. Actions speak louder than words. That all of that is, we are an emanation and a manifestation in the world based all the way back to the origin, which is the matrix. Perception. The filters. And am I willing to give up all of my beliefs? Now, this is not easy. I can tell you that this is a challenge for most of us. To be willing to give up all of my beliefs, my current really firmly held beliefs that I believe are true? Am I willing to give those things up so that I can see a bigger and better version of God and humanity and the earth and the entire system? Am I willing to give up the things that I've held so dear so that I can see a greater picture? We're all invited into that. But the willingness must be there. And then people who will say yes and will say amen to this, we need to remember also that we can become, even people who are in new thought circles, can get to the place where you start to spiritually bypass, and then you're basically doing the same thing again. You're just doing it under a different label. And see, and I'm not crazy enough to think that in 50 years from now, 40 years from now, maybe 20 or 30, in 100 years for sure, that there won't be people who will coalesce around what I'm saying right now and what other leaders are saying right now and create yet another level of religion. At some point, the human being tends to want to build memorials which require concrete or something of solid substance to weigh it down. And I'm not crazy enough to think that somebody will not take texts that we're writing now, messages that we're sharing now, and in some ways concretize it. But at least let's try to move this forward a little further. Let's at least try to move humanity a little further down the road toward a higher level of manifesting what is possible for all of us. So life and death are in the power of the mind. What you think about, you will eventually bring about through your words and through your actions. Yet, if we look a little more deeply, the mind is actually a servant of the matrix. So, this is one of the reasons I think that Eckhart Tolle says, not only are you not your thoughts, you're also not the thinker of the thoughts. Go further back. Get further back into what you really are. Because when I say to someone, you're not the thinker of your thoughts, automatically our brains start being messed with because we identify with the brain. But the brain is the thinker. You're the one who's aware of the thinker. You're further back even than the thinker itself. You're even further back than the matrix. And the reason we know this is because we're aware of the matrix. I am the awareness itself that's aware of the matrix and knows that I can clean those filters and or remove those filters that have been imposed on me by others and maybe chosen by me. You see, we are sold a bill of goods and some of us purchase it and some of us live by it and we're so strong on what we believe that many of us, even when we're shown the truth, won't change because if nothing else, we're too proud to say I might have been wrong. I believe there's some people doing that right now politically who have just held the line for a particular candidate. They've just held the line for whoever that may be. It doesn't matter to me, whoever it may be, but you've held the line for so long that you're not even able to see the truth anymore. And when it's presented to you, are you able to detach from those things that you've been so attached to long enough to see if they even serve you anymore? I encourage us to consider doing that. To be able to give up the matrix, give up the mind, give up the mouth so that you can change the manifestations of your life. This is not about blame. Remember, this is it's never about blame. When we're talking about taking responsibility for the life you're manifesting, I'm not talking about blame. Don't get into blame because that's the ego's way on the other side of things to start making you feel a sense of shame or a sense of guilt. This is not about blame or shame. This is about responsibility, and your responsibility is just your ability to respond. It's the power that you have to respond to the life that you have been living and decide whether you want to continue to live that life or create a different life. And that will only happen when we start to examine the matrix that's influencing the mind, which is influencing the mouth, and creating the manifestation. If we look a little deeper, we will see that the mind is actually the servant of the matrix. The filters, the theological framework, and the sociological gridwork that all discriminate, decide, and deliver what that all discriminates, decides, and delivers what the mind gets and how it gets it. Matrixes like education, experience, and exposure. So what you've been educated to believe, what you've experienced as a result of that belief, because some of us, and I'll say this is one of the things I've noticed recently. many of the people who have believed that the earth is going to be destroyed and that God's going to sneak his favorite people out the back door and he's going to curse the rest of the planet are in some ways literally becoming their own self-fulfilling prophecies. This is one of the reasons we have chosen a different line of prophecy. That the earth is wonderful, that the earth is beautiful, that this is the place that we were intended to be and to have a life of abundance right here, right now on this planet. That there's nowhere I need to go to discover God. I can go right within. I don't have to go off into the cosmos somewhere. That Jesus is not coming back to split the eastern skies, literally. Maybe Jesus or the Christ presence is splitting the eastern skies metaphorically within us, so that we can see the heaven that is already within and then begin to manifest it out into the world. But your education and your experience, sometimes the experiences you've had even lie to you about the truth because you've experienced what you strongly believed because you manifested what you strongly believed. So matrix is like your education, your experience, and your exposure. That Trinity sometimes has caused you to believe in a particular paradigm, a particular way of seeing the world. Filters like culture, country, and class. Many of us don't realize that our culture here in the United States directly influences how we see the rest of the world. That's why nationalism, which I personally think is gross. This belief that we're the best country in the world, where you know, it's just recently we saw all of the prophecies about how all of a sudden, since we were going to see a direct line of the solar eclipse in the United States, all of a sudden that God was going to come and get his favorite people, but ignoring the fact that on other parts of the planet, there have been solar eclipses, but I guess God's an American. Many of us don't even realize the grossness of that because we've been raised for God and for country. But filters like this, our cultural belief systems, our country, our particular class, the reason that we end up with classism, racism, sexism, homophobia, all of these other things, religionism, is because of the class most of us were raised in. And we essentially believed, either taught it directly or at least osmosis, that our way of being was the right way. I've said to you before, most of us as human beings, psychologists say, that most human beings wake up every day essentially believing they're right about everything. Now, you would maybe never say that, but there's an essential belief within you that you're pretty much right about everything. I mean, in fact, if you woke up, it's more than likely it's a self-preservation thing, because if you woke up and you were very aware of all of the things you might be wrong about, you might not ever get out of your bed. So for the most part, I think it's a self-preservation thing, but can we become aware of that? That I am filtering the world and everything I'm experiencing through this sense of I know everything, that I'm pretty much right about everything. And can we get to the place where we can release being right and more readily move into being kind? The root word for kind is kin. That we're kin, we're one with everyone else on the planet. So filters like culture, country, class. All of this unseen force field decides how and what information gets to the mind. Again, we don't read the world as it is or see the world as it is. We see it as we are. And before a piece of information gets fully processed, first it goes through our culture, our country, our class. This unseen force field decides how and what information gets to the mind. Finally, we arrive at the matrix, the origin. Death and life are in the power of the matrix that filters the information to the mind, that controls the mouth, and ultimately determines the manifestation. So our mission, listen to this, calling us to this, our mission as awakened spirits is twofold. First, we must be aware of this matrix, this mind, this mouth, and this manifestation connection. We must be willing to be aware of how the matrix, the mind, and the mouth, and the manifestation are connected. And that our lives or manifestations are directly connected to how we process information and then what we choose and how we choose to declare it. Second, let's ask the Holy Spirit to remove the filters, to take away the biases, to delete the prejudices, to extract the religious leanings and the cultural learnings so that we can perceive neutrally. I like this right here, purely, clearly, and cleanly, whatever the Holy Spirit sends to us. This way we're not merely manifesting with our mouths, minds, and matrices more separation and segregation into the global human family. Am I willing to be challenged, not just in my mind, but in the matrix, that field of filters? Am I willing to be challenged within that space so that I can be more mindful of what I'm manifesting in the world, how I'm showing up, so that I can be more clean and more pure? Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me, and take not the Holy Spirit from me. So the Holy Spirit is here to create in me a clean heart and renew an accurate spirit within me. Am I willing to adjust the matrix that influences the mind, that directly influences the mouth? Because all of that is directly influencing how I'm manifesting and what I'm manifesting in this world. So today I ask us really into a sense of repentance, metanoia, which means to change your mind, or when you thought, think again. To think again is really one of the meanings of repentance. And am I willing to rethink everything? The next time something occurs, someone that you deem to be, I don't know, unlearned, not awakened, rigid, sinful, evil, terrible, are you willing to challenge that belief? Whew. Folks, this is not easy, okay? This is not easy stuff. But this brings us back to the Jesus code of resurrection, where Jesus said to love your enemies, to do good to those who are attempting to harm you, to pray for those who are oppressing you, to bless those who are cursing you. That's what we're talking about. Am I willing to repent, possibly repaint a different picture within my matrix, so that I can actually see purely and cleanly, clearly, what I'm working with? As I've mentioned to you before, in any given situation, instead of becoming overwhelmed with whatever's happening, ask Holy Spirit, help. And I love Michael Beckwith says, help really is hello, eternal, loving presence. Hello, eternal, loving presence. Show me what's real. Help. Hello, eternal, loving presence. Show me what's real in this situation. Don't show me something that's going to prop up my agenda, but show me what's real. Are you brave enough to do that? That's really what this is about today. Matrix, mind, mouth, and manifestation. Here's our prayer for today. Master, I surrender my matrix. I surrender my mind. I surrender my mouth and manifestation to you. I give it all up. I surrender my matrix, mind, mouth, and manifestation to you. Amen. And so it is. And our affirmation one more time. Life and death are in the power of how I see and say. My matrix processes it. My mind presents it. My mouth proclaims it. My manifestation produces it. Today, I will be aware of the matrix, mind, mouth, and manifestation connection. And so it is. And so it is. And these are just thoughts to carry with you throughout this week, to see if you can shift some of the manifestations you're experiencing in your life by going all the way back to its origin, which is the matrix. that's been influencing the mind and giving the information or maybe inflammation to the mouth to declare. That's the invitation to repent, metanoia, rethink, think again, so that you will know, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Let's say it this way and I'll close. Rethink, because the authority of God is what you're wielding with your hand. And is what you're wielding a sword? Or is what you're wielding a healing instrument? So retool yourself. Just like Jesus did when it talked about Jesus going up and went out, according to the English Bible, to be tempted of the devil. In the Kabor's manuscripts, it said Jesus went out to be tempted of his own self or his own ego. I lean toward that, that is the devil. The devil is the ego. So that he could retool himself. So that he could reattune his true self. Are you willing to do that? That is the challenge this week as we go throughout the rest of this week and this season, where we are given this power to narrow the gap between what it is we're saying we want with our mouths, with our actions, and what it is we're manifesting in reality. Okay? Beautiful. All right, my friends, I want to say thank you for being here as always. Thank you for being a part of this community, and I encourage you to share this with someone that you believe may be blessed by it. Pass it along to someone, send them the link, tag their name in the comments, tag them. Please make some comments. It helps with the algorithms of things. And continue to give financially. I appreciate you doing that. It's all so that we can continue to do this, to show up and share what I believe are life-changing messages. I believe we'll apprehend these principles. I'm not saying do exactly as I say to do, but take something from this and see how it can enhance and upgrade your life. Utilize that. Maybe there's something in what's being said or sung that can be a blessing to you. And I encourage you to share that with others. Okay, my friend, I hear the music getting started. I'm going to get up out of here now. Go and make it a great day and a great week, because you can. See you Tuesday.